Welcome to my YouTube channel. Today I'm going to show you on how to connect a thermal relay overload to a contactor and how a doll starter is made or direct online starter. In my previous video, I showed you how this works and now we are going to connect it. This is the relay. And then we have our contactor here, which is normally open. And then we have this start button, which is normally open, and our stop button, which is normally closed. Then this is our lamp. It will act like a motor. So we start our connection. So this get fixed directly down here. That's how it's connected. Then there are nuts here that hold it. Make sure it's tight. Loose connection is not good. Now we have connected our overload here. Live 1 goes through T1 and then through the overload, then it comes down here to T1. Live 2 like that and live 3 like that. Since we are connecting it to single phase, first we will connect our neutral, this is where we are getting our power from. This is our neutral. When we put this on, it will go direct down here. Then we will get our neutral. That is our neutral. Yeah. When we bring our neutral to the coil here, we loop our wire. Our neutral we will connect it to live 3 here because it's a single phase. And then this last part here, we will use it as our auxiliary. So you loop here another black that will supply to the coil. So live 3 here is our neutral. A place indicated L3. So that's where we will connect our neutral. And then this neutral here goes to A1 down here at the coil. Our coil is down here, so you connect our neutral there. Now we have our neutral to the coil and our neutral to the light here. This neutral goes directly down here. Like I said, L1 goes to T1 and comes to T1 down here. So we are connecting at T1, which will be connected to L1 when the coil is energized. Now our neutral connection is complete. Now we go to the live. So our live will connect it down here. To T1 down here. Yes. T1 down there. And then we'll get a live. First we get our live from here. This is our live from the MCB. Now we are going to connect it to live 1. This one will connect when the coil is energized. It will connect this live 1 to down here. But we have to connect another one here for the control switch, for the control circuit. So we have two wires there. One brings power and the other one takes down there to the auxiliary auxiliary here. This one that collects power from here, we take it down here to this auxiliary, which is normally closed. 95 is close to 96. So you put it, you connect it to 95. You connect it to 95 there. When it's connected to 95, then from 96 here, have our 96 here, you will connect it to number 1 here. Number 1 here at the stop button, the red is the stop button. It's normally closed. And then from number 2 here, this is number 2, you'll connect it to number 3. It's written here, number 3 here, you'll connect it to number 3. I have to make sure it's tight. Connect it to number 3. And then from number 4 there, number 4 of the start button, number 4 of the start of the stop button, you will connect it to number 13 here. But before you tighten it, again you loop from number 13 up here. And then it will supply to the coil. The coil is down here. The coil is down there. You can see a screw down there. The coil is down here. It is down there. So this is not yet self-holding. I want to show you. This works in sewing machines or a machine that requires instant stopping and instant starting. So we put on this. So this one you can put on like that and off. If you stop holding, it stops. So you push, stop. Push, stop. So we want it to self-hold for a machine that takes long, works for longer hours, longer minutes. So you introduce another wire. So you will go to either number 3 or number 2. Up here you add another wire. So you open here. You have to switch off first. So you put another wire from here to number 3. You can put it either from number 3 or number 2. And then you connect it here, number 14 down here. Connect it to number 14. To number 14 down there. And now our connection is over. Assuming this is a motor, you put on your circuit breaker. So it's now self-holding. So you put it on like that. It will remain on until somebody comes and presses this button, which is the stop button. That's when the machine will stop. That's how simple it is. Like and subscribe for the next video. Thank you.